so quickly. A little philosophy. I have not tapped into it for a while. I haven't been going like, well, what about that headspace wonder, you know, your karmic reality, you know, you're born into this world, and what do these other people represent? You know, I haven't really talked about that too much. Now, with philosophy, you can have, there's all different theories and takes, and you can say that person there is a representation. I'm only seeing them, they only exist, they're only in my reality because of something that I am with inside. You know, they're literally a mirror of my own self, you know, a mirror of the terribles that I have inside, the hurts, the pains, the goods, the bads, all of it. So that's what other people are, like, they're in that represent, you know what I mean? And it works, you know, you can ring it and it goes, yeah, and I kind of understand it, but it's a selfish state, obviously, to look at. They're only like a representation, like a cell with inside your body, like this one is warped, and therefore that's just a warped person that I'm seeing or that's around me, because that's a representation of the cells within my own body. You know, so I'm surrounded by the warp, or I'm surrounded by only the pleasure people that are never a problem. That means, you know, I'm in total fit health. You know, you can look at it this way, but it comes to difficult, you know, when you look on the world scale and you bring your body into the world scale. When you're on the world scale and you have like the serial killers, and then you have like the wars that break out, and you have the people that are going from these tragic refugee situations, and you have the droughts, you know, and then you have actually the planet symptoms itself, you know, also, you know, going, wait, it's not just humans, you know. The planet itself saying it's part of you and represent, you know, your drought inside is that drought that's going on in Ethiopia. That's a drought within you, you know. And then people go, well, you're nuts to say all that. But that's just theory, you know. We're talking philosophy, theory, getting into the mind space and, you know, how it all happens. And is it relevant? Is it relevant to bring up this option? You know, is it relevant at all? Because it still is like it's still a query you're gonna have. You know, because we're all wandering on this earth. You know, as human beings, each one of us, you know, playing as a god, and you know it. You can say you're not, and there's an almighty in your head or whatever. But you're still playing your life as a god over other people. Your ego is greater. Even when your ego is beaten down as low as it can go, you're still the greatest ego over everybody else. That's just the way it goes until you're dead. We are that way. We're ego survivalists. Without that ego, we die. So here we have like the person, the extravagant person, you know, in my surrounding self right now, you know, and you can look at your surrounding selves, you know, as those people, you know, as your health tone, you know, your actual health. Now, wonderful, the internet is kind of neat because I come along to witness people, very interesting, like this one woman, I think her name was of Roth or something, or Rochberg or something, but she was this very, I think she's very popular and famous, but she's very health guru, and she eats this one salad every day. And so I'm like, well, okay, so she's eating this one salad every day, and I keep thinking, well, maybe that is really, you know, a representative inside me, that I have a cell inside me that is saying, eat like her, you know, I want to be energetic like her. And so I'm getting this power moment through this one cell saying, I want to be just like that woman. I love her. I love her energy, her spirit, her vigor, her courage. Just this massive bowl of salad, you know, and it's comical, and it's a cartoon event. And with that, absolutely, that person could absolutely live within inside my God self. So it's very interesting when you look at life that way, that these people like pop into our lives, you know, especially out here on this internet, get more and more like obscure in a way. And those obscure connections, they become more humorous and more comical sometimes as to yes, absolutely, you know. That one is just yelling and screaming at me, just to eat like her, I love it. And yet I have all these others that are in their tantrum state, going, no, we eat this way, or this other one over here saying we eat that way. And so they're the tug and pull of your disciplines. But when you take that extravagant outlook, you know, that you are the karmic body, you are the only karmic body, and everything else is just a reaction to your experience of embodiment. If that's the way you look at it, they're just a reactive event. It's not just them. It's the clouds, it's the stars, it's the planet. It's the volcanoes that go. It's everything. It's all encompassing. So, and I know there's a lot of you out there that do want to tap into your God self, and that's fine. Absolutely fine. I have no problem with it. As long as you don't hurt people in the process. As long as you don't hurt. So what was I going to say? Okay, so the problem we're having, okay, because now we know our body, and I'm saying with this theory, we have this rearrangement, okay, I have the cells in me, and they're all great and wonderful and positive and cheery, and they really oddly are excited by my diet, but I am not, yeah, don't talk about the banana kingdom, it is like, I almost like feel jovial sometimes. And that's unusual, because I haven't felt jovial for a very long time. Jovial, yeah. Okay, so here's this represent of all of these cells. They're doing their thing. I have some really good healthy ones. And then I have some that are like, maybe not so healthy, you know. They're overreactive. They're perhaps overreactive to anger issue, or overreactive to drama. And then I'm like, oh my God, how do I part the overreactive to drama one? How do I get rid of that cell, you know? That almost becomes, that's another life story. I don't think you can. That's really, you know, dealing with the personality God, your personality God, and he or she, that personality God of you, is really, really powerful. It's a real powerful one, isn't it? Once your personality is set, it's a difficult one to renegade into something else, isn't it? Okay, so here, now I'm looking at all of these health cells or unhealth cells that I'm carrying, and then I'm like, well, wait a minute, this is getting pretty hectic, you know, all these people, I can't keep track of them, and why am I responsible for serial killers, and why would I be, you know, why would my body, my God body, be responsible for them, You know, it's just ludicrous. You know, it's becoming ludicrous. You know, and then I'm like, well, so then I have to start switching my theory and go, it's not, it doesn't work that way. I have to turn off the keys to that car and go, no, it has to, we have to look at it more like it is, those people are a cancer on the planet. Those types of people are just a cancer. And if we look at them as walking, talking cancers to the earth, you know, people who hurt the planet, people that intentionally hurt others, they're cancerous. You know, they're cancerous to the good. You know, when you take away that we as human beings are not just necessarily multipliers, that we actually have brains also and can heed that behavior and not populate to kill the earth. If you take that into account, okay, now if you're looking at the bad, the evils that exist as humans, that are edging and destroying human beings and destroying the planet, we just have to look at them as outright cancers. Now those are external to me. They're external to me. But so it takes away from the God body, doesn't it? It takes away from the God body self, because the God body self does not want to accept them. It's saying, well, the God body self, I'm now pushing my God body self out. I'm pushing it out, and I'm giving it, I'm going to hand over those keys to the planet. And the planet now has a cancer. So I'm looking at my little tiny God, is now pushing it out to the bigger God, which is planet Earth. And I'm going, oh my gosh, I see your cancer. I see it. And it is those bad humans. It's the bad humans that destroy. It's the bad humans that humiliate and injure and kill on purpose. It's those bads that are the cancer. So yeah. Anyway, so I'm trying to get there where the God cloud of self exists. I'm trying to move it to the planet cloud of God, the planet God. Alright. And I don't know. That helps a little bit. Helps a little bit, but then now I'm just another disassociated human, aren't I? I'm like, oh, well, that was easy. I got rid of it. I'm not taking any responsibility in my insides. My health structure does not have anything to do with it any longer. So in a way, that is bad. In a way, that is bad, isn't it? Because I want the gel. I want that gel fixture that each human is an associated connection with this planet, God. So, and that means my personal health. It means that next person's personal health and that person over there's personal health. All association to the planet being a cancer or the planet not having a cancer. Yo-yo-yo-y. Gets confusing, doesn't it? Philosophy can get confusing when you get into your God self. And then there's 7 billion or 10 billion human beings, and they're all disruptive, or some days they're not as disruptive, or only half of them are disruptive. Yeah, it gets confusing. Because yeah, everybody wants an answer in this one little video. I'm not going to supply it. I'm just giving out the theory of where you're just to represent a mirror of me, a mirror of a part of me that's hampered or good and positive. That's who you are. In your represent. So in a way, if you look at it as me connected, like a tunnel, connected tunnel to the planet, like I'm absorbing in my positive nature, my good and my non-destructive self as much as possible to survive. If I absorb in that way, and then yet I'm having a ping out of the planet, and that person is an evil. Well, is it that my ego is not big enough? It's not powerful enough to alter and change that one. You're getting into the self. It's really complicated. God, me, planet, God, bad person. Okay, so we have those three. You could say it's an acute triangle or an obtuse triangle, but it's getting, or angle rather. Rather than, because if you look at it directly from you to that person, it just does, it's not jiving well, is it? It's just not jiving. You know, if you look at us harvesting our harvested selves, like a weird movie, our harvested internals plugged in to the planet, the galaxies, and all our harvested energies, just socketed in. We'll say to planet Earth, I'm socketed in, okay. And then yet there's this other person over there that's trying to short-circuit my socket. You know, they're trying to short-circuit my socket. Their socket is wrong. Their wires are crossed. They're crimped. They're having electrical discharge. They're not good energy connected to the planet. Because they're not good energy connected to the planet. Their line, their connection line, is hurtful, okay? So my power absorb is not hurting, and theirs is, okay? So, and because we're all connected to this planet Earth, that dude over there who is hurtful to other human beings thusly is creaking in just because I'm plugged into the planet, you know? Is affecting. Do you understand? He's affecting good people. Affecting good people and hurting good people. Because we're all plugged in to the same earth. Okay. Human self, me. I think that's all I'm at right now with it. I can't go any further. Now, if I have on board, you know, cells on board, if I have a few rotten ones, and I'm plugged into the planet with my rotten cells, I, in turn, am refeeding that out to others. I'm refeeding that out through my planet socket connection. You know, you can't deny our current. Our current is hoisted here. We're hosted and hoisted here. Walking, talking, breathing, electrical discharge current. Okay, so any of my negatives are affectants to other currents. And so, thusly, my negatives on board, I can go with this, we can go with this full circle. My negatives on board, let's say I have a cell that's broken, it's collapsed, it's a disruptor, it is a not healthy, it is on the verge of cancer. Let's say I have something like that on board and I'm plugging in. Well, that very, very well, it becomes a feeder current. a negative feeder current to those people that are evil, becomes a negative feeder, and they can, why not, enlarge, they can increase. You know, if they are fed negative, that they were getting all their energy from anyway, you know, if they're being refed the negative, you know. So I guess in my full circle here is we cannot be feeding out, we cannot even have these negatives, we got to get rid of them, but that we can't be feeding them at all back into the planet and then giving them away to even more negatives. Do you understand? So the negative to the negative, to the double negative in a way, or triple or quadruple, whoever those horribles are. Ay, it's tough to try to say, hey, I'm gonna be a utopic human being. It's very tough because of the negative onslaughts. You know, and we're like, I'm getting the feed negative, even, you know, through my nice little connection to the planet, you know, I'm getting it shot through to me, you know. And I'm like, oh, sometimes it's the news or whatever, and you just like turn it off, and they'll blast some horrible person's face. You see this on the line all the time. You go to like any of these news channels, and they'll put this horrible person's face right in your eyes. You're like, how dare you? How dare you try to interject horrible person to me? How dare you? How hurtful. You know, why would you be spreading the horrible person? You know, I see this all the time. They're just like trying to decimate the horrible people within us. You know? Ruin my good connection? And then I'll say, yeah, go to hell. Yeah, go to hell. We are the good connection. You know, we're not wanting to be jabbered with some terrible person who just killed somebody or this, you know, I don't want that person given so much. You know, you're giving them so much. It's almost like what they are living off of, the spread of their disease. Look what I did, ha! You know what I mean? And the news media is allowing that. So anyway, beautiful, happy world that I'm connected to. Positive current flow into it. That's it. That's all we are to provide. I'm not supposed to do anything other except be that share world self. And then, you know, the more you can rise above and not be damaged. And the higher your charge is through to that planet, then yeah, people will say, you are more and more enlightened. You are more like a god. They will say that. It's that higher charge energy where they're not disrupted. And no, you can't just turn off your concentration key of those people. I don't believe that's it either. I don't think you can just turn off that key. And just be, you know, well, I'm not gonna be affected by block, you know. In a world attack, when you're getting a ping attack, essentially, like computer system talk, you're getting a ping attack of negatives, denial of service attack, all of those. When you're getting that attack to you, you know, coming in through planet world, somebody's really trying to hurt you. Somebody's trying to knock you off your cloud, your God self, and they have no right. They have no right to do that at all. We're all supposed to be God selves, every one of us, and be beautiful and wonderful and positive current back into this earth world and our galaxy. Saza. Okay? That's it.